How can we understand the difference between a pathogen and a pathobiont? Great question for Dr. Michael Ash on the Functional Forum.
Whereas I want to talk about how to rejuvenate and re-stimulate and recreate a relationship with the bacteria and the viruses and the fungi and occasionally the nematodes that live inside you. Because the difference between our interconnection with what is harmful and helpful bacteria is not so much a separate language. It's more like a change in tone. We're not dismissing the relevance of pathogens. What we're going to do is try to extend the nomenclature, the knowledge, and the understanding that there's a drift. Just as Dr. Chatterjee shows you the line between optimal health and disease, there's also a line in bacteria between those which are helpful and those which are problematic. Essentially, it's the difference between an argument and a civil conversation. Most people here enjoy health in which the bacteria and the viruses that share the moist environment that you've generously donated to them do so with a reasonably civil daily conversation. Effectively, you've outsourced boring, responsible jobs to your undernourished, often underpaid employees, for which they willingly slave away every day, producing metabolites, immune maturing content, and also create different types of nutrients that you wouldn't otherwise be able to extract from your food to keep you alive. And they do this for a pretty miserly salary. It's basically a warm, wet, fairly slippery environment in which they get the occasional bit of food to munch on. That constant communication with our microbes and the messages are broadcast throughout the human body. They don't just stay within the gastrointestinal tract. Now, for most of you who've listened to me go on about this over the last 20 years or so, this is not new. But for many people entering functional medicine for their first time, or even listening to this sort of presentation for the first time, the idea that we have a dialogue with organisms that are difficult to see with the naked eye, that influence every thought and every action that we commit to, is sometimes a bit of a shock. The metabolites that our body functions on and works on, 80% of those are entirely related to the dynamic interrelationship with the bacteria, which are found in their greatest abundance in your colon and your small intestine. If we don't recognize their role in our ability to maintain health and also to prevent disease, we're doing ourselves a great disservice. More and more research papers over the last few years are trying to expound a model around this concept. And I like this one back in 2013, which is a more holistic understanding of what constitutes gut health will ultimately guide future approaches to correcting gut dysbiosis. And the answer surely lies in the consideration of the entire microbial ecosystem rather than its individual components. Now, first of all, you rarely see the word holistic in a standard medical journal. And then secondly, they're trying to extend that concept in that we would somehow or other be able to take a genomic sequence of all the bacteria and the viruses inside our gastrointestinal tract, and that would provide us with enough information to be able to intervene and reverse problematic situations. The first time we're going to see this word today, the dysbiosis, I'm going to cut up what I think is a very elegant explanation for what dysbiosis is by a friend and colleague, Dr. Vasquez, where he says a relationship of non-acute, non-infectious host microorganism interaction that adversely affects the human host. And the first thing here is it's non-acute and it's non-infectious. This immediately moves us away from the conventional reductionist emergency intervention therapy. They're non-acute and non-infectious. Although acute and infectious events can leave you with a dysbiotic gut, in most cases, NCDs are presenting with a low-level dysbiotic change. And I'll explain how that occurs and what events lead to problems.
Thanks so much for watching. And for more great clips like this, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. I've created a special free video just for you called Harnessing the Power of Community in Your Practice, and it'll give you a clinical model, practical tools that double as marketing, and strategies to develop a community of your peers. All you have to do is click on the link below.